To Attitudinal Healing International's 2018 webinar series called Attitudinal Healing Around the World. Today we are welcoming Dr. Zaidi DeFranco from Dominican Republic. We are so happy to have all of you participating today, and we know that you're going to learn a lot from Zaidi and have an opportunity to look into your own life and apply the principles and concepts that Zaidi will be sharing in your own life. Dr. DeFranco is a doctor of dentistry and the executive director of Sakura Santo Domingo in the Dominican Republic. As a speaker, therapist, and soul's companion, Zaidi addresses forgiveness and attitudinal healing as a path of self-realization. She teaches and demonstrates a new mindset that implies a profound change in our perception of the world, ourselves, and each other. Today's webinar is called Conflict Addiction. In today's webinar, Zaidi will identify the origins of our internal conflicts and give us antidotes to experiencing conflict that leads us to more inner peace. Zaidi, it's my great pleasure to welcome you. At the end of Zaidi's talk, you'll have an opportunity to ask questions and to interact, and I'll give you some instructions about how to do that at the end of Zaidi's talk. Welcome, Zaidi.
Thank you, Trish. I am really glad to share all attitudinal healing wisdom with all of you, my personal experience. And this is a giving and receiving thing. I know I'm going to give you my point of view of what is conflict addiction, and I know I will learn about you as well. I will speak in English, and also I will be translated with a company of Janet Clemente. She is a facilitator of attitudinal healing. And she will read the Spanish slide. Welcome, Janet. Bienvenida, Janet. Apague el micrófono. Bienvenidos a los de habla hispana. Yo soy Zaidi DeFranco y estoy aquí para enseñar mi forma de ver la curación de actitudes y lo que es la adicción al conflicto. Y sé también que voy a aprender mucho de ustedes con sus preguntas y sus comentarios al final de esta conversación. Como lo dije en inglés, también estaré dando esta conferencia en inglés y en español, y Janet es la persona que me va a acompañar, siendo ella facilitadora de curación de actitudes, leyendo las diapositivas que están en español. So let's begin with this topic, that is conflict addiction, symptoms and detox treatment. Our objective learning at the end of the webinar, participants will be able to identify the source of internal conflict, their earnings, their symptoms, and may apply a conflict detox treatment that you will see very soon.
Al finalizar la conferencia, los participantes estarán en la capacidad de identificar el origen del conflicto interior, sus ganancias, sus síntomas y podrán aplicar su tratamiento.
This is the program that we are going to share. We are going to see what is conflict, the fear as a source of conflict, like the belief system, that is the ego. We will see the psychological and physical symptoms of the conflict, the change of attitude, and our detox treatment.
¿Qué es el conflicto? El miedo como fuente del conflicto, ego, síntomas psicológicos y físicos del conflicto, una cuestión de actitud, tratamiento detox.
What is conflict? For me, is any kind of thought that separates you from something or someone, which pretend to damage you in any way and in any degree, only because it despises, limits, rejects, or weakens your being.
Cualquier tipo de pensamiento que te separa de algo, que pretende dañar de cualquier forma o en cualquier grado, aunque solo sea porque menosprecia, limita, rechaza o debilita.
So we can see that conflict born from a thought is it is not anything that is beyond you or outside you. Our conflict, we generate conflict with our thoughts. Nosotros generamos conflicto con nuestros pensamientos. No tiene nada que ver con lo que ocurre fuera. Siempre viene de un pensamiento. Conflict feels like negativity, and all of us know what is negativity. It's directed against something external or against yourself.
El miedo como fuente del conflicto. Sistema de creencias basado en el miedo y la culpa, que es el ego.
El conflicto se siente como negatividad. Puede ser dirigido tanto a nosotros como a otras personas. Fear as a source of conflict. The ego is not something that you feel like superior to someone else. It's a belief system based on fear and guilt. And we feel that we are separated from someone else. We are feel different or special. El sistema del ego es un sistema de pensamiento basado en el miedo y en la culpa. Y te hace sentir separado de las otras personas o especial. Tú eres diferente a los demás, tú tienes cosas mejores que otras, en diferencia con los demás. The ego tells you, you can search, but never find what you're looking for. Never, but never find what you are looking for.
El ego gasta energía prediciendo el futuro según las experiencias del pasado, siembra dudas e incertidumbre.
Let's tell Janet that is the anterior slide. Es la anterior. ¿Puedes buscar?
Sí, donde dice que el miedo como fuente del conflicto.
Sí. Okay. The ego. It worries with condemnatory judgments. It spends energy predicting the future according to the experiences of the past. It sows doubt and uncertainty. It is ambiguous and ambivalent, and it is characterized by complexity and not by simplicity. It is important to know that those are our thoughts. The ego is not outside us. It is in us. So it is important to hear that voice and know that it is not our essence. It is our ego part, our separated mind.
El ego busca, pero no encuentres jamás lo que busques. Eso te dice el ego. Se preocupa con juicios condenatorios. Siembra duda, incertidumbre. Es ambiguo y ambivalente. Gasta energía prediciendo el futuro según las experiencias del pasado. Se caracteriza por lo complejo y no por la sencillez.
El ego no es una parte que está aislada de nosotros. Es nuestra mente separada la que cree en la separación. Y es importante escuchar esa voz para saber que no es nuestra esencia. Y es una voz que podemos cambiar. The ego believes in thoughts of attack and defense and is a master of disappointment. It controls everything and believes that in its own way everything is fine.
El ego, pensamientos de ataque y defensa, y es un maestro de la decepción. Controla todo y cree que así todo está bien.
When we speak about conflict addiction, we are speaking about anger and resentment. And sometimes we feel or think that we don't feel anger, or I'm not a resentment person. But we are, in so many ways. Nosotros creemos que no tenemos ni rabia ni resentimiento, que no sentimos nada de eso, pero sí, nos lo sentimos en muchas maneras. Y la adicción al conflicto viene dado por estos dos sentimientos. Anger. We will see what is anger and what is resentment. Anger is a primitive feeling. The human one is inward and the animal one is outward. It always hurts the person who generates it. Beneath the rage lie deeper feelings like pain, fear, insecurity, and someone and so others.
Rabia. Sentimiento primitivo. La humana es hacia adentro. La animal es hacia afuera. Siempre hace daño a la persona de la fábrica. Debajo de la rabia yacen sentimientos más profundos, como el dolor, miedo, inseguridad.
So, my friends, let's begin to think and to feel. What are those feelings and thoughts that we are generating in ourselves? This is the time, the only time there is, our present, that we can see what we are hiding. Es importante que en este momento empecemos a ver, a pensar, a sentir cuáles son esos sentimientos y esos pensamientos que hemos estado ocultando por mucho tiempo. Es tiempo de, en este presente, que es el único que existe, pues de darnos cuenta de todo lo que hemos guardado. Anger and resentment. It is a feeling of deep and persistent rage, an ingrained exacerbation that unbalances and sickens the body and mind. The origin of the resentment can be due to several reasons: insults, trust abuse, deceit, offenses, sexual abuse. Resentment builds up until it finally turns into a desire of revenge. And all of us have desire of revenge. If you tell to someone or don't tell, we always feel something. And the difference is, what are we going to do with those feelings? Are we going to be resentment and anger all of our life? Or I'm going to lose the fear to feel everything that it is inside me. It doesn't make me a bad person to feel those feelings and to have those emotions. The difference, like I said before, is what are you going to do with those feelings? Todo el mundo tiene rabia y resentimiento, y en alguna medida todos en algún momento hemos deseado tener ese deseo de venganza, de que alguien desaparezca. Lo que nos diferencia es lo que hacemos con esos sentimientos, si los reprimimos o los sacamos. Es importante perderle el miedo a sentir esas emociones, porque son de humanos. We are going to start, and please be very attentive with this. We are going to start with the 10 psychological symptoms of conflict. The first one, and please write your symptoms. The first one, stay angry because it gives you a feeling of having more power and dominance. You are only hiding feelings of helplessness, insecurity, disappointment, grievance, or fear. Nosotros vamos ahora a prestar mucha atención a estos síntomas psicológicos del conflicto, y el primero es
permanecer enfadado porque te da sensación de tener más poder y dominio. Solo encubre sentimientos de impotencia, inseguridad, desilusión, agravio o miedo.
The second one is to use anger as a drive and fuel to get things done. You chained yourself to an angry character, generate resistances in others, and establish a conflictive environment.
Utilizar la rabia a modo de impulso y combustible para conseguir que se hagan las cosas. Te encadena a un personaje colérico, genera resistencia en los demás y se establece el ambiente conflictivo.
So be, please check your psychological symptoms. Así que por favor vayan viendo cuáles son sus síntomas psicológicos del conflicto. Number three, you use anger and resentment to control others. When you get angry with someone, they get scared or feel guilty. And for us, it's easier to manipulate them. Using fear and guilt in your relationships implies that you consider them useful for you, and therefore give them, meaning, and credit. Then you live controlled by the ego. It is possible to manipulate through anger, but you pay a high price. You lose peace. If you control, you are being controlled. One of the pillars of conflict is to have control of everything and everyone. And it's one of the most important symptoms of a conflict addiction. And all of the symptoms are based in the ego, and ego is based on fear. So, why we are so fearful? Es importante, ahora cuando lean el slide en español, ver que uno de los pilares del conflicto es el control. Y el control viene dado por el ego. Y el ego viene basado en el miedo.
Utilizar la rabia y el rencor para controlar a los demás. Cuando te enfadas con alguien, se asusta o se siente culpable y es más fácil manipularlo. Usar el miedo y la culpa en tus relaciones implica que los consideras útiles para ti y por tanto les das sentido y crédito, entonces vives controlado por el ego. ¿Es imposible o es posible manipular mediante el enfado? Pero pagas un alto precio, pierdes la paz, y controlas, estás siendo controlado.
Psychological symptom number 4. Use anger and resentment to avoid communicating. You can see the picture. That's the way we feel inside us, because we don't know how to communicate. El síntoma psicológico número 4 es utilizar la rabia y el resentimiento para evitar comunicarnos. Y están viendo en la foto cómo nosotros nos sentimos por dentro.
Sientes miedo a expresar tus pensamientos y sentimientos, o temes las consecuencias de decir la verdad. Considerar la comunicación como una amenaza lleva a la obcecación y al aislamiento, lo cual nunca sirve para solucionar nada.
Psychological symptom number 5. Use anger to feel safe. Who use the anger to feel safe? I do. By using it, people stay at a distance because they are scared. It is a method of isolation and security. The rage is used to separate and isolate you from the world, being a reaction that arises from the fear to face it. Right now, I am 85 pounds less than my original weight. And I used to feel anger, to feel safe. And the way I did was gaining weight. Thank God I accept my feelings and liberate them and free them, so I can be a healthy person, inside and outside.
Al utilizar la rabia, la gente se mantiene a distancia, pues está asustada. Es un método de aislamiento y seguridad. La rabia es utilizada para separarte y aislarte del mundo, siendo una reacción que surge desde el propio miedo a afrontarlo.
Y como le decía a las personas que hablan inglés, yo utilizaba mucho esta forma de reprimir la rabia para sentirme a salvo. Y les decía que los que me ven ahora, tengo 85 libras menos de peso. Y las tengo porque tuve todo ese peso de más, porque utilizaba ese peso para sentirme a salvo, pero en el fondo tenía mucha rabia con los otros y conmigo misma. Al aceptar ese sentir, lo pude liberar y por ende ahora puedo vivir de una manera sana, tanto internamente como externamente. Psychological symptoms number six. Use anger as a way to affirm that you are right. You give yourself value by showing that you are better than the other. Normally, the other will fight against you to defend him or herself, or he/she will feel hurt. So this is a classic symptom of conflict addiction.
Te confíes valor al demostrar que eres mejor que el otro. Normalmente el otro luchará contra ti para defenderte o se sentirá herido. De modo que se trata de un síntoma clásico de la adicción al conflicto.
Y ese es el síntoma número 6, que es usar la rabia como forma de afirmar que tenemos la razón. Number 7. Use anger to make you hear. When you have the impression that you are not taken into account at all or are ignored, so the real reason why you oppose and get angry is to demand attention. And if you see in the slide, there is a kid that is very angry. So it is important to see our children if they are really asking for love. They are demanding attention.
En el punto 7, se utiliza la rabia para hacerte oír. Cuando tienes la impresión de que no se te tiene en cuenta en lo absoluto o se te ignora, entonces el motivo real por el cual te opones y te enfadas es reclamar atención.
Y en la diapositiva ven a un niño con rabia. Y es importante ver a nuestros niños cuando están pidiendo ayuda para amar y cuando están pidiendo atención, demandando atención. Number 8. Hold rage to avoid the feeling you cover. Sometimes anger is more comfortable than fear, sadness or disappointment that you cover up. Underneath the conflict addiction is resistance to looking at the feelings that lie under the rage and the resentment. Peace and mental liberation requires us to stop hiding what is there. Only understanding heals. And it is important to explain the phases of our emotions. The first one in the triangle, in the top of it, is rage. And like I said before, the rage is the emotion that it is more rapidly to express. But underneath the rage, it's pain. So we don't want to feel pain, and we repress it. So what we are going to share with everyone, our rage, because it's more easy to express rage than pain. When you think about that, what am I going to show to everyone? Am I going to show my pain, or am I going to show my rage? And if you feel it, it is easier to express rage than pain. But underneath the pain, it's fear. So why we are feeling the fear? What is so fearful to us? To see that others discovers what I am thinking about me, really. But underneath the fear is guilt. And guilt is an emotion that is in our unconscious mind, and it's a collective one. Everyone feels guilty. Guilty to think that we are separate, we are apart from God, when we are only one. God is in us and we are in God. Those are the phases of our emotions. Rage, pain, fear, and guilt. Es importante que describamos cuáles son las fases del conflicto y de nuestras emociones. Es mucho más fácil nosotros sentir rabia que sentir dolor. Y es una pirámide. En la punta de la pirámide tenemos la rabia, que es la emoción que más fácil podemos expresar y es más rápida, pero debajo de la rabia yace el dolor. Y nos preguntamos, ¿qué quiero yo expresar? ¿Expreso la rabia o expreso el dolor? Y es más fácil, como les dije, expresar la rabia primero antes que el dolor, porque sería descubrirme por dentro. Pero debajo del dolor existe el miedo. Miedo a que me juzguen por sentir dolor, miedo por muchísimos pensamientos limitantes. Y debajo del miedo está la culpa por sentirme separada de los demás, separada de Dios. Cuando realmente Dios está en mí, yo estoy en Dios y somos uno. The psychological symptoms of conflict, number 9, is use anger to keep you in your position as a victim. When you identify yourself with the victim costume, there is an enormous resistance to forgive, since you would lose this identity. If I gave up my favorite resentment, what topic of conversation would I have left? You can open yourself to greater joy by not needing to suffer to receive attention.
9. Utilizas la rabia para mantenerte en tu posición de víctima. Cuando te identificas con el disfraz de víctima, existe una enorme resistencia a perdonar, ya que perderías esta identidad. Si renunciara a mi rencor favorito, ¿qué tema de conversación me quedaría? Puedes abrirte a una mayor alegría al no necesitar sufrir para recibir atención.
Number 10. You continue to feel resentment for not being responsible for what you feel or what is happening in your life, in the present moment. While you cling to rage, you can always blame the other. This makes you impotent to change your life. You lose the power and you give it to the other person or situation that you blame.
Yes. Continúas sintiendo rencor para no responsabilizarte de lo que sientes o de lo que sucede actualmente en tu vida. Mientras te aferres a la rabia, siempre podrás culpar al otro. Esto te hace impotente para cambiar tu vida. Pierdes el poder y se lo otorgas a la otra persona o situación a la que culpas.
Am I going to solve all the problems outside me? Am I going to wait to the to all the world be perfect to start being happy? ¿Estaré yo esperando que todo lo de afuera se arregle para yo sentirme feliz? ¿Estaré yo en la posición donde todo tiene que estar perfecto para yo ser feliz? We are 100% responsible of what we think, what we feel, and what we do. It's not the other person that makes me feel bad. It's my interpretation of what I see of those things that occurs outside me, that cause me anger and cause me conflict. No son solamente las cosas de afuera lo que me hacen mal o lo que me llevan al conflicto. El 100% de responsabilidad de lo que pienso, siento y hago es mío, de nadie más. Nadie me hace vivir un conflicto. Lo hago yo con la interpretación que doy. So this is the summary of the 10 psychological symptoms of conflict addiction. We saw the power to have power in others, like a motor too, and to have control of the other situation, to draw attention, security, to be right, to blame, to avoid communicating, feeling, or facing an issue, and a victimism.
Tenemos el poder, el motor, control, llamar la atención, seguridad, tener razón, culpabilizar, evitar comunicarme, sentir o afrontar un asunto, victimismo.
Esos son el resumen de los 10 síntomas psicológicos del conflicto. I think you took notes about your psychological symptoms of conflict addiction. Me imagino que han tomado notas sobre sus síntomas psicológicos de la adicción al conflicto. But we have also our physical symptoms of the conflict and are the disease. Absolutely all diseases or physical diseases have an emotional beginning. We get sick because of a thought. And I will repeat it. We get sick because of a thought. Ahí tenemos los síntomas psicológicos, síntomas físicos del conflicto. Y todas las enfermedades, absolutamente todas las enfermedades físicas, vienen dado por una emoción. Todas las enfermedades físicas nacen de un pensamiento. And we have some examples of physical diseases like hypertension, duodenal ulcer, urticaria, palpitations, insomnia, fatigue, cancer, thyroid disease, hernias, etc., etc., etc.
Síntomas físicos del conflicto: tenemos hipertensión, úlcera duodenal, urticaria, palpitación, insomnio, cansancio, cáncer, enfermedad de las tiroides, hernia.
So, are you sick right now? Do you have any disease? Because if you have some disease or condition, now you know that it has a beginning in a thought, in an emotion. So what are those emotions that you are repressing for all these years? Es importante saber si estás enfermo, si tienes una condición, cuáles son esas emociones que estás reprimiendo por tanto tiempo, porque son las emociones que tenemos que liberar. Those emotions are the ones that we have to let go, to free them. And how are we going to do that? Changing our attitude. We have the power to choose our attitude no matter what is happening around us. It has nothing to do with the things that are outside. It is a gift we are giving ourselves. Our internal peace is our own gift. Attitudinal healing is a practical tool that will help you to disidentify yourself from conflict and return to peace. It consists in healing our mind and heart and having harmony between our thoughts, emotions, and actions, practicing attitudinal healing principles based on love and forgiveness. Es importante saber que la forma de nosotros evitar el conflicto es cambiando nuestra actitud. Nosotros tenemos el poder de elegir nuestra actitud sin importar lo que suceda a nuestro alrededor. Es un regalo, nuestra paz interior es un regalo que nos damos a nosotros mismos. Nadie puede darnos ese regalo, solamente nosotros. La curación de actitudes es una herramienta práctica que nos ayudará a desidentificarnos del conflicto y a retornar a la paz. Consiste en sanar nuestra mente y nuestro corazón y tener armonía entre lo que pensamos, sentimos y hacemos, practicando los principios de curación de actitudes que están basados en el amor y en el perdón. And what is the treatment of our addiction of conflict? The antidote, like Tris said, is forgiveness. So let's see what is forgiveness. Como dijo Tris, nuestro antídoto para esta adicción al conflicto es el perdón. Así que vamos a ver cómo podemos eliminar esa adicción con el perdón. Forgiveness starts from within. Forgiveness is healing yourself.
El perdón empieza desde adentro. El perdón es sanarse a uno mismo.
Forgiveness, it is the will to free oneself from the painful past. It is the decision not to continue suffering, to heal the soul and the heart.
Es la voluntad de liberarse del doloroso pasado. Es la decisión de no seguir sufriendo, de curar el alma y el corazón.
It is changing our perception of the world, of others and of oneself.
Es cambiar nuestra percepción del mundo, de los demás y de uno mismo.
It is to feel compassion, tenderness, and consideration no matter what seems to happen at that moment in the rest of the world.
Es sentir compasión, ternura y consideración sin importar lo que parezca ocurrir en este momento en el resto del mundo.
It is the path that leads to peace.
Es el camino que lleva a la paz.
But what is not forgiveness? What forgiveness is not? Forgiveness is not to justify negative behaviors of your own or those of others.
No es justificar comportamientos negativos propios o ajenos.
Forgiveness does not require you to communicate directly with the person you have forgiven.
El perdón no exige que te comuniques directamente con la persona a la que has perdonado.
Forgiveness is not forgetting what happened.
No es olvidar lo sucedido.
It's not doing everything right. It is not repressing.
No es hacer que todo va bien, no es reprimir.
It is not adopting an attitude of superiority and submitting or punishing the forgiven.
No es adoptar una actitud de superioridad y someter o castigar al perdonado.
It does not mean that you have to behave in a specific way.
No significa que tengas que comportarte de un modo específico.
Forgiving has nothing to do with behavior. It is an internal attitude.
Perdonar no tiene que ver con el comportamiento. Es una actitud interna.
And I want to stop a little bit here because most people say that to forgive is to forget what happened. And our mind cannot release those experiences or forget those experiences that had an impact in us. Like Jerry Jampolsky said, forgiving is to remind our past, but not with pain. Es importante que nos paremos un momento aquí porque perdonar no significa olvidar lo sucedido. Como dice Jerry Jampolsky, el creador de curación de actitudes, perdonar es recordar sin que nos duela. Eso es como tener una cicatriz. Forgiveness is not mean that you have to behave in a specific way. And we have learned that if I forgive, I have to act normal with that person that hurts me. And it's not true. I have the option to have a relationship with that person or not. This is my choice. It's not, okay, I forgive. Now I have to spend my whole life with that person. We don't have to act like that. Me paro en la parte de que perdonar no significa comportarnos de una manera determinada. No significa que yo tenga que actuar de una manera normal con la otra persona, porque no es así. Yo puedo perdonar y no estar en una relación con esa persona y puedo liberarme. So let's see now our, I don't know how to tell the recipe or our steps of forgiveness. So if we can practice this that I'm going to share with you, I assure you that we will be in peace. So aquí les traigo las indicaciones del perdón, los cinco pasos del perdón, y yo les aseguro que si llevamos esto a práctica, nosotros podemos ser felices y estar en paz. The first step of forgiveness is to feel. Is accept your feeling as it is without judging it. What happens when we feel emotions that we don't want to feel? We are repressing that. And it converts in physical diseases when we don't honor those feelings. El primer paso para perdonar es sentir, es aceptar nuestros sentimientos como son, sin juzgarlos. Porque muchas veces no queremos sentir esos sentimientos que no nos gustan y lo que hacemos es reprimirlo. Entonces es importante honrar nuestro sentir para que no se convierta en enfermedades físicas. The second step is to tell ourselves, all the conflict is in my mind. I abandon the projection and recognize that the conflict is due to an interpretation in my mind, an incorrect perception of reality.
Todo el conflicto está en mi mente. Abandono la proyección y reconozco que el conflicto se debe a una interpretación en mi mente, una percepción incorrecta.
If I want to feel peace, I am responsible to change my perception of the reality I see. Si yo lo que quiero es paz, es importante que yo sea responsable de cambiar mi percepción de lo que yo veo fuera. The step number three is, I do not know, is to practice humility. I discard all programmed judgments, one by one, about the person or situation to forgive, saying, I do not know, to each of them, as they appear in my mind. It is true that what I'm thinking is the reality? I don't know. It is important to let go or our expectations of another person or a situation. I have no control of what is going to happen outside me. When I say I don't know, I am asking help from the higher self. Because the higher self really knows what is the real truth. We always think with our expectations in mind and not with our true self. Cuando decimos no sé, estamos siendo humildes, estamos pidiendo ayuda a nuestro ser superior, estamos no pensando ni sintiendo desde nuestras expectativas, sino desde ese poder superior que habita en nosotros.
No sé. Desmonto todos los juicios programados, uno a uno, sobre la persona o la situación a perdonar, diciendo, no sé, a cada uno de ellos, según aparecen en mi mente.
Number four, I choose to change my perception. I want to see beauty. I want to be happy. I choose peace. I choose to see with the eyes of love. I ask for help. I choose to change my perception. I am determined to see differently. I give my mind. I leave myself in the hands of the self.
Cuatro. Elijo cambiar mi percepción. Deseo ver belleza. Deseo ser feliz. Elijo la paz. Elijo ver con los ojos del amor. Pido ayuda. Elijo cambiar mi percepción. Estoy decidido a ver de otra manera. Entrego mi mente. Me dejo en manos del ser.
Number five. And the last one is number 5. I accept the healing. I accept what it is. I enter in tune with the acceptance of my life experience as it is, or of the conflicting event as it happens.
Acepto la sanación. Acepto lo que es. Entro en sintonía con la aceptación de mi experiencia de vida tal y como es, o del suceso conflictivo tal como pasó.
So with these 5 steps of forgiveness, those 5 simple steps, we can let go all the conflict that we are experiencing right now. Con estos pasos, estos 5 simples pasos del perdón, podemos liberarnos de todo el conflicto que estemos experimentando. Because this moment is the only one that exists.
Este instante es el único que existe.
We only heal in the present moment. Solamente podemos sanar en el momento presente. The past cannot hurt us. Only can hurt if we bring it to the present and make those to remember the past hurts. So what am I going to decide now? El pasado no puede perjudicarnos, no puede hacernos daño. Solamente si lo traemos al presente y pensamos en él de forma dolorosa. To forgive is a choice that it doesn't have to do anything with the person that we think hurt us. El perdón es algo que nos debemos a nosotros mismos y no tiene nada que ver con lo que pensamos que el otro nos pudo hacer. We can see the other person as our teacher, as a gift to us. Those persons that we think hurt us are the messengers of God to remind us that we have the power to choose again and to choose peace, to choose happiness, to choose and choose again and again. And we are free to choose what is more peaceful to us. And what is more peaceful? The thoughts that we are going to integrate in ourselves. Es importante saber que las personas que creemos nos hicieron daño son personas que son nuestros maestros. Cuando yo empiezo a ver a esas personas como maestros, veo que son regalos de Dios para mí, para recordarme que yo puedo elegir ser feliz. Y puedo elegir una y otra vez. Siempre puedo elegir ser feliz, sin importar lo que suceda. If we are going to think more in our future and not in our present, we are going to be conflicted with our thoughts too. Si nosotros pensamos sobre el futuro, si nosotros pensamos más en lo que va a pasar en el futuro que en lo que va a pasar en nuestro presente, estaremos también alimentando el conflicto. And now in this hour that we have left, I want that all of you share what are your thoughts. If you have any questions, this is a giving and receiving, like the principle. Giving and receiving are the same. We are teacher and student one another. So please share with us or your thoughts or your if you have any questions, and Trish will explain how to do that. Ahora yo quiero que podamos compartir.
Thank you so much.
Quiero que compartan sus preguntas, sus comentarios, porque esto es una situación de dar y recibir, y de que todos somos maestros y discípulos unos de otros. Así que les voy a dejar con Trish para que ella nos explique cómo hacer las preguntas.
Thank you.
Thank you
for sharing. You can click on that icon. And Zaidi will see that you want to speak. Do you want to translate that, Zaidi, and then I'll continue?
Yes.
Thank you.
Ustedes verán en la parte superior de su pantalla donde dice meetings, hay uno como un hombrecito, una persona levantando su mano. Pueden darle clic ahí y así poder ver quiénes son las personas que quieren compartir. Y así le puedo dar permiso para que puedan hablar y compartir su cámara.
So you can click on it to make it green, and that tells you your microphone is on. Go ahead, Zaidi.
Pueden ver,
And finally, if you would like
está
to
el
see
micrófono,
you when you speak,
tienen
you can
que ponerlo en mute,
icon
o sea, silenciarlo,
right
y todos los que están aquí, para que luego cuando puedan levantar
icon.
La mano, la persona
so
que quiere hablar, entonces activarlo dándole un clic para que se ponga verde y sin la línea atravesada. También si quieren compartirse, o sea, para poderlos ver, a la derecha del micrófono se encuentra la cámara donde pueden darle clic y empezar a transmitir o empezar la cámara. Es posible que tengan, cuando se vean, den a Start Cam, para que puedan entonces nosotros ver.
Trish,
it is important to remember those that doesn't have microphone that they can put their questions on the chat. Las personas que no tengan micrófono pueden escribir aquí debajo sus preguntas o sus comentarios para nosotros entonces poderlo leer y puedan participar. So, who wants to raise their hands? It is very important to share what we are thinking about this topic. Are we seeing each other or inside us as a conflictive person? Do I recognize that you have rage or resentment? Es importante que podamos compartir nuestro sentir, nuestros comentarios y saber, ¿estoy yo siendo una persona conflictiva? ¿Estoy aguantando en mí toda la rabia y resentimiento? Alma González says, Sairi, it is rage a manifestation of the lack of forgiveness for oneself. Alma nos dice, Sairi, ¿es la rabia una manifestación de la falta de perdón a uno mismo? Of course, Alma. It is a really good question. Yes, rage is a manifestation of the lack of forgiveness for ourselves. Sí, es así como lo dices, Alma. Es una manifestación de la falta de perdón a uno mismo. Por no poder cambiar la situación externa, creemos que tenemos el poder y el control de cambiar todo lo externo. Me culpo por no hacerlo y lo que sube a mi conciencia es la rabia. La rabia porque no puedo controlar lo externo. Y sí, sería una máscara de todopoderosa. I told Alma that indeed rage is a manifestation of lack of forgiveness of oneself, because we don't forgive ourselves for the thought that we can control everything. If we think we have the power to control everything and everyone, and we project that, and we see that we cannot control anything, we cannot forgive ourselves for the lack of control. So what is going to go up of our conscience is rage and resentment from ourselves. And Alma said, it is like a mask. Yes, it is like a mask that, like, we think that control is a superpower. Nosotros pensamos que el control es un superpoder. And it is not. Y no lo es. Control is a lack of confidence in God's power. El control es la falta de confianza en el poder de Dios. Thank you, Alma. Carola wants to ask a question. Carola wants to ask a question. Por favor, escríbela. Please write it. What is Carola's question? So yes, we think that we control everything and it is not. So knowing that, what am I going to choose? Peace or conflict? It is our choice. Only our, it's our responsibility. Creemos que el control, tenemos el poder de control y no lo tenemos. Entonces, ya sabiendo esto, ¿qué es lo que vamos a elegir? ¿La paz o el conflicto? Es 100% nuestra responsabilidad. Carola, ¿tu pregunta? Anyone can raise your hands to. ¿Cuál es tu pregunta, Carola? What is your question? Carola said, okay. Carola wants to share then point number 10 of addiction of the conflict addiction. Yes, we can explain a little more of the let's find number 10. Oh, I pass it. Carola said that it is hard to her to feel responsible of everything she feels. She wants to that I explain with more detail that if she's totally responsible of what she feels and thinks. Carola, lo diré primero en inglés y luego en español. I'm going to explain that first in English and then I'm going to explain in Spanish. I'm going to read again the slide. One of the psychological symptoms of conflict is when you continue to feel resentment for not being responsible for what you feel or what is happening in your life in the present moment. While you cling to rage, you can always blame others. This makes you impotent to change your life. You lose the power and you give it to the other person or situation that you blame. When we hold victims, when I prefer to give the responsibility of my happiness to others, I'm being a victim. I'm feeling that the other person is responsible of what I think and what I feel and what I do. And it's not like that. Like I said before, forgiveness is not to justify the things that are wrong, but forgiveness is to choose peace instead of conflict, instead of everything is occurring outside me. I know it is hard when someone else has hurt you. To think that, oh, Saidi said that I am responsible of what the other person did. No, the other person has their responsibility of their acts. We are responsible of the interpretation we are going to give of that reality, of that action. It is my responsibility to see that the thing that occurs with another perception, So the question I have to ask myself is, am I going to live this experience in peace, or am I going to feel this experience with conflict? It is a responsibility, not the other person's responsibility. Nosotros, cuando tenemos un conflicto, creemos y es más fácil darle la responsabilidad de lo que pasó a la otra persona. Es más fácil y más cómodo quedarnos en el disfraz de víctima, de que el otro lo hizo mal y por eso yo me siento mal. Nosotros somos responsables de lo que pensamos, sentimos y hacemos con esa realidad, con eso que pasó. El perdón no significa que yo soy responsable de las acciones de los demás. Lo que significa es que el otro es responsable de sus acciones, pero yo soy responsable de la interpretación que yo le voy a dar a eso. Y es mi libertad elegir si voy a vivir esa experiencia desde la paz o si la voy a vivir desde el conflicto. Y eso no es responsabilidad de la otra persona, es mi responsabilidad. Porque lo que yo pongo en mi cabeza, en mi corazón, y lo que yo hago con eso que ocurre, solamente depende de mí, no depende de lo que el otro pudo hacer. Bien, te contesté tu pregunta, Carola. Gracias. I was asking Carola if I answered her question, and she said, yes, thank you. Tataka said, how do you work with a person who denies their addiction? Satoko said, ¿cómo trabajo con una persona que niega su adicción? The first of all, I first work with the feelings of the person. I'm not telling them that they are addictive or because they are always being in denial. So I'm helping them with those questions too. So I ask them, what do you feel right now? Do you feel happy? Do you feel sad? What do you want for yourself? I do not work focusing on the problem. My work is in help the other to change their perception. And there is where miracles can work, when we are changing our perceptions of ourselves and the other and the world. Le estoy diciendo que no trabajo con el conflicto, con el problema per se, sino que mi trabajo mayormente viene dado al acompañar a las personas a cambiar su percepción de sí mismo, de las otras personas y de alrededor. Thank you, Satoko. Gracias, Satoko. It is important to, when I work with attitudinal healing and forgiveness, I don't like to label the person that comes to me, because in essence, we are all the same. We are love. Cuando vienen las personas donde mí por consulta, yo trato de no etiquetarlos, porque en el fondo todos somos lo mismo, todos somos amor. And it is important to know that and remember the person that we are not the one who heals the other person. We heal each other with the help of God. I'm not the one that knows everything about forgiveness. I am only an instrument from God's wisdom. So I can share that wisdom with the other persons. Estoy diciendo que que cuando viene la persona donde mí, yo no soy la persona que sano al otro, porque yo no tengo ese poder. Nosotros sanamos unos a los otros por medio de la sabiduría de Dios, y pido la sabiduría de Dios para que pueda entonces ser entregada a los demás. Alma said, if I have a family that think that all that I speak with him is a conflict and react with conflict. Si tengo un familiar que todo lo que hablo con él es un conflicto y reacciona conflictivamente, okay. Alma, contestaré en inglés y luego en español. I will answer first in English and then Spanish. It doesn't matter if your relative acts with conflict or reacts all the time with conflict. That's not the thing. The thing is, what are going to be your reaction or your expression of interpretation of that feeling of your relative. We cannot change the attitude of the other person. We can change our attitude and we can change our perception of my relative, because it is not my choice that he or she acts with conflict, but it is my choice. How am I going to interpret that? Lo que le acabo de decir es que no importa si el asunto no es si la otra persona reacciona siempre conflictivamente. La pregunta es cómo tú vas a reaccionar y cómo tú vas a interpretar esa reacción. Si tú la interpretas desde el conflicto, pues estarás aumentando el conflicto. Si lo interpretas desde la paz, lo vivirás en paz. No importa lo que pase a tu alrededor, lo importante es saber qué yo voy a elegir ante esa situación. ¿Puedo elegir paz o puedo elegir conflicto? Esa es mi decisión, no la de la otra persona. Mary Candulo said, Saidi, please explain how you got in touch with your feelings in relation to your weight loss. Oh, I love that question. Mary nos pregunta, por favor explícanos cómo te pusiste en contacto con tus sentimientos en relación con tu pérdida de peso. Oh, to remember that is really a very good feeling, because this has been a very loving process, an easy one too, because I start my forgiveness process not to think that I will lose weight. This process was accepting my humanity that is perfect with its limitations. Estoy explicando que recordar con esta pregunta mi proceso de pérdida de peso, de liberar el peso, ha sido un proceso muy amoroso y muy fácil, que he empezado pues por amarme y aceptar mi humanidad limitada, que es perfecta. Mary, when I accepted myself as a whole, a perfect expression of God, love, that when I accept that I am living an humanity experience, being an spiritual self, I accept that all my feelings are right, and it is that I lose my fear to feel human emotions. We are here for something, and it's to learn to be happy. If you are fat, if you are slim, it doesn't matter what your how your body looks. The thing that matters is that you are perfect in God's love, and it is okay to live your humanity experience. If not, we cannot be perfect with the ego mind that is humanity, but we are already perfect with the self mind, the conscious that it is God. So I accept both. I accept the duality that I am experiencing, knowing that duality doesn't exist. So I accept my humanity with my emotions. All my emotions are right. So I give myself permission to feel those emotions. That's the first step of forgiveness. I feel the pain. I feel the anger. I feel everything. It is okay to feel because we are human. We are experiencing humanity. And it's perfect like it is. Thank you. I can see your self-worth and love. Oh, thank you. So I'm going to explain now in Spanish. Les decía que este proceso es un proceso muy amoroso, un proceso donde realmente acepté mi humanidad. Yo acepté que soy un ser espiritual viviendo una experiencia humana y que está bien vivir nuestra humanidad limitada. Yo no puedo pretender ser perfecta desde mi mente egoica que cree en la separación, pero sí ya soy perfecta desde mi esencia de amor, desde el amor de Dios que es uno y que vive en mí. Es importante integrar tanto mi parte humana con todas mis emociones, con la rabia, con el dolor y decir como el primer paso del perdón, yo siento. Siento rabia, siento dolor, me permito sentirla. Es ser amables con nosotros mismos e integrar nuestra experiencia humana. Queremos vivir una perfección divina desde nuestra humanidad cuando no es posible. Acepto mi humanidad limitada y desde mi esencia vivo mi perfección. Thank you, Mary, for your question. Anyone else? Who wants to make a question or write their comments? Let's see if there is anyone to raise their hand. No one. To know the conflict or the addiction that we are having, it is important to our healing process. El conocer nuestra adicción o nuestro conflicto es muy importante para nuestra sanación. Not because we are addictive or we are going to label ourselves like addictive person. What I want to share is that it doesn't matter if you are psychological ill or physically ill. The thing is that you can heal by healing your mind, by healing your thoughts. And healing your thoughts is to change them. I always said that our mind is like a supermarket. When we enter to a supermarket, we don't know, we don't have control of the products there inside. But we have the power to choose the products that are healthy for ourselves. So if I choose an a product that it is not healthy, and I see that, I can see that, oh my God, I choose a non-healthy product. I have the power to take it back. So I have, again, the power to choose products that are healthy for me. And it's the same with our mind. We don't have control of our thoughts that comes and goes. But we have the control, and not the control, we have the power to choose those thoughts that are healthy for oneself. So, am I going to choose thoughts? Am I going to integrate to myself thoughts that are peaceful, or am I going to choose thoughts that are ego-minded? That's my show, my choose. This is my election to do. This is my responsibility. I cannot blame anyone for the thoughts that I am integrating. And the thoughts come from the from my interpretation of the reality based on my past experiences. So am I going to choose again with conflict, or am I going to choose with peace and knowing that the present is the only time there is? It is my choice. It is my choice to be happy. It is my choice, my choice to live in peace. It doesn't matter what is going to occur in outside me. I don't care about the things that happens. I only take them to learn the way I am living those experiences. Because always it's my responsibility to choose peace or choose conflict. Es importante saber en el proceso del perdón que, y siempre pongo este ejemplo del supermercado, nuestra mente es como un supermercado. Nosotros no tenemos control de los productos que están en el supermercado, pero sí tenemos el poder de elegir los productos que sean más saludables para nosotros. Sí, he escogido un producto que no es saludable y me doy cuenta o no es saludable, tengo la libertad de retirar ese producto y volver a elegir productos que me hagan sentir bien, que sean saludables. Entonces, así como el supermercado, nuestra mente, no tenemos control de los pensamientos que van y vienen, pero sí podemos elegir los pensamientos que sean más saludables para nosotros, los que sean de paz. Si he elegido un pensamiento conflictivo y si lo integro, va a ser mi responsabilidad el haberlo integrado. No es la responsabilidad de nadie más, es mía. Entonces, la pregunta es, ante una situación cualquiera que sea, ¿voy a escoger la paz o voy a escoger el conflicto? Mi felicidad no depende de lo que ocurra alrededor. Mi felicidad depende de la interpretación que yo le doy a esa realidad. Eso es lo importante. ¿Voy a experimentar esto desde la paz o lo voy a experimentar desde el conflicto? Es mi elección. Anyone else? ¿Alguien más quiere hacer su pregunta? This is like the principle that we are teachers and students from oneself, and I am learning a lot about with you with your questions. Trishy is typing something. Let's wait. Trish, if someone wants to forgive but they don't know how to start, what do you suggest? Trish dice, si alguien quiere perdonar pero no sabe cómo comenzar, ¿qué sugieres? Well, Trish, I suggest that accept that they don't know how to forgive. This is humility, in to know that we don't know how to do it. Le digo a Trish que lo primero que le diría es que aceptara que no sabe cómo perdonar, que está bien que no sabe hacerlo, que lo reconozca. When we accept that we don't know how to forgive, then the power of love, God itself, give us give us the, I don't know how to say it, they enlighten us with his thoughts. When we ask for help, we are open our hearts to the miracle. And then all the answers are, we can, all the questions about forgiveness are answered by God, and we can hear that voice inside us. So this is my suggestion, is to accept that we don't know, and then we will know how to do it. Le digo a Trish que lo primero que hay que hacer es saber que no sabemos nada, y que es entonces cuando podemos traer esa sabiduría de Dios a nosotros, y todas esas preguntas sobre cómo perdonar, todas esas preguntas serán contestadas, y cuando podamos abrirnos con esa frase, no sé, entonces sabremos, y sabremos cómo perdonar. Thank you, Trish. Anyone else? Mary? Let's see. I'm really happy to share everything with you and my experience. Mary said, decide from asking someone what they are feeling and what they want for themselves. What else can be discussed? Decide from asking someone what they are feeling and what they want for themselves. What else can be discussed? What we want for ourselves. Dice Mary, aparte de preguntar a alguien qué están sintiendo y qué quieren para ellos mismos, ¿qué más podemos discutir? Pues le digo lo que nuestra experiencia, lo que nosotros queremos para nosotros mismos y lo que queremos sentir. The way I work, Mary and all my friends, is sharing my experiences. I can ask them, the people, what they are feeling, but when they see that we can open freely to express our experience, they will get confidence to share with you. So it's going to be very natural to talk with the other person when they see that you are exposing yourself and you are not afraid to share your humanity, your limitations with them. Le digo que mientras uno se abre al otro y comparte sus experiencias, es más fácil que el otro también se abra. Muchas veces el otro tiene resistencia a abrirse. Y cuando nos escuchan y ven que nosotros nos exponemos, ellos también entonces lo hacen y ganan confianza para hacerlo. Thank you, Mary. Who wants to raise their hand? And I want to see you in the webcam. I only seen your question in the chat. Who wants to expose themselves? Please raise their hands if you want. Okay, Mary,
hello,
you can
baby.
Turn on your cam.
Very nice to be here with you.
Let's see. Mary, you raised your hand. Can you turn on your webcam, please?
I want to tell you how happy I am right now. I want to just share my feelings of joy and happiness. Because I
Hello, Mary.
Am feeling a lot of
nice
love.
To see you.
A lot of love for myself and a lot of love
We cannot
for
hear you.
Happening here for
please
this
turn on your microphone.
To be a part of attitudinal healing. It's so beautiful.
Hello, Mary.
Okay.
Sure, thank you.
Thank you. Do you want to share something else? And how come? Oh, that's fine. Thank you. I will translate what you already said, okay?
Thank you.
So Mary said that
someone else an
that she feels very happy
Thank you, Zadie.
To share with all of you. And this is I'm saying in English, Mary.
Hey, how are you?
Oh my God. Well, Mary está diciendo lo bien que se siente con ella misma, el amor que se está dando y lo grato que es compartir con todos los de curación de actitudes. La verdad que se siente muy bien y muy agradecida. Thank you, Mary.
We've been wondering, we are in Syracuse, New York. Yep.
Thank you. You're welcome.
Okay.
Anyone else? Tara! Hello! I'm really happy.
Because this has overall been so, it's been such a wonderful reminder and summary and just a shift in looking.
Oh, thank you. Really, thank you. Where are you from?
In your groups. You have
from New York.
How do you share it?
Aquí está Sara, I'm going to translate, okay? Está Sara con dos amigas y están desde Siracusa, Nueva York.
Okay.
Y que se siente muy feliz de también de compartir todo esto. Do you want to ask me something, Sara? Or one of you? Okay, I'm going to translate. Sara nos está preguntando que, bueno, que esto es una experiencia muy profunda y que si yo hago, ¿cómo comparto esta experiencia? Si lo hago a nivel individual o lo hago con grupo. Ahora le voy a contestar y luego le traduzco. Well, Sara, in Secura Santo Domingo, we have healing groups. So we can share, and we have 12 facilitators that were trained from us in attitudinal healing, and we have our attitudinal healing group, and we share the principles, we share the guide of attitudinal healing. You know, we can share everything, and it's the same, but in another part, always is different. Because are the same principles, the same guy. But people come to the group with different experiences. So our goal is to demonstrate them that they can choose again. They have the power to choose, like I said before, their thoughts. Because we cannot change our emotions. We only have to feel them so they can be free. If I don't feel my emotions, I will repress them and I will suffer. It is different to suffer and to feel pain. It's not the same. When I suffer, I repress in my original pain. And I resist to feel them, to feel my pain. When I choose to feel pain, I honor what I'm feeling right now in the moment. I don't judge myself for feeling those feelings.
Sure.
I honor them. I give myself permission to feel in a healthy way. That is to honor, to accept that I'm feeling this way. And to feel my pain or any emotion that I have, it will lead to freedom and it will lead to feel peace instead. Just accepting. May I translate that before? Thank you. Le estoy diciendo, explicando, que cómo trabajarlo en el grupo, cómo nosotros como facilitadores lo que hacemos es llevar a las personas a que reconozcan lo que están sintiendo, a que nosotros podamos ser una guía para que ellos acepten su sentir, sí, y que hay una diferencia entre sufrir y doler. Cuando yo sufro, estoy reprimiendo el dolor original, no lo estoy aceptando. Y cuando duelo, cuando elijo doler, estoy aceptando el sentimiento como es, la emoción como es, me acepto a mí con el sentimiento y esta es la única manera en que lo puedo liberar y así poder elegir de nuevo la paz. Yes, now you can ask me a question.
Through this, and then through their sharing, do they lead by example? Does that make sense?
Okay. Thank you. Okay, yes. In another hand, I have my personal practice. It's like to do conferences, workshops, and that is the way I am sharing this. What am I doing today? I try to do my conferences and my workshops in Secura, in our center. So people that are coming to our group also can know this information. This presentation will be available for you. Trish will send the presentation to all of you. the Spanish one and the English version too. So you can share it with all your groups. You're welcome. I'm going to translate now. Le estoy diciendo que aparte de la parte de Secura, en mi práctica privada doy conferencias, doy talleres y esta es la forma en que yo transmito este mensaje. Pero que de todos modos esta presentación va a estar disponible para todos ustedes, tanto la versión en inglés como la versión en español. Ustedes estuvieron escuchando a Janet que nos estuvo traduciendo los slides, pero ustedes tendrán toda la presentación para ustedes. O sea, es importante que lo sepan. Ok, Trish said, will you also share about your other online trainings and workshops? Yes. Ok. First, Trish me está preguntando que, me está diciendo que por favor comparta las otras cosas que tenemos. Ok, in Secura Santo Domingo, we have developed an online and presence training called, it's a training in attitudinal healing. We have two programs. We developed the first program that is 14 weeks living attitudinal healing, one principle at a time. We have the introduction section that is number one and the closure section that is number 14. But we have 12 weeks practicing attitudinal healing one principle at a time. It is available right now in Spanish, it's not in English, but we hope that we can share it too with you. And we have our healing groups. We have three groups, one of adolescents and two of adults. We also have, we are going to start next March our club of conscious reading club. We are going to share all Jerry and Diane's books in this lecture reading club. This is the other activity we have. We also have the facilitator training program that you can do it just if you did the 14 weeks program. So it's a year of knowing and interiorizing attitudinal healing. It's a very complete program. So we are growing. We in Secura Santo Domingo this year we are going to celebrate our 9th anniversary. So we are working a lot. And yes, I have a radio program. It's called a Soul Path. In Spanish, it's Camino al Alma, Soul Path. And I shared all that I shared already with you and my experience too. So yes, I collaborate in another radio program. I write in Secura blog, and I write in another paper's work. Yes. Estoy diciéndole todas las actividades que hacemos en Secura, donde tenemos nuestra formación en integral en curación de actitudes, que es un programa de 14 semanas que hemos desarrollado, es propio de Secura. Y tenemos también, en ese programa vivimos la curación de actitudes, todos los principios una semana a la vez. También tenemos charlas mensuales donde podemos Tenemos otros temas que ayudan también a la sanación. Tenemos la formación de facilitadores de curación de actitudes. Y tenemos, en marzo comienza el Club de Lectura Consciente, donde estaremos compartiendo todos los libros de Jan Polsky. We also have monthly conversations or conferences with the facilitator group. So every month, one facilitator of attitudinal healing of the Cura Santo Domingo share a topic about attitudinal healing. So we are working a lot, yes. Anyone? To end this, all my radio program are on my Facebook. You can see in the screen all information about Secura, the web page, the phone number, and our email. And also, I'm sharing my personal information, my email, if you want to write, if you want a one-on-one session. I can do it online too. I do therapy with people in the United States, in Chile, and there is another country that there is a person.
Wisdom,
I think it's Mexico that is
been really an inspiration
taking therapy online.
Here,
I do it online and
such
in
a
presence.
Joy to be with you.
So this is my social
feel your heart,
my social information.
And I hope that we have
in Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram, and Skype. So you can write to me and ask me anything you want. I'm here to, like my slogan said, I'm here to share and
yes,
expand
thank you, Jeanette.
What is healthy
it's wonderful
for us.
To be able
that is love.
To hear your presentation in
Trish?
Both languages. And I think it will well you did a fabulous job, both of you. I can't even, I can't imagine trying to do that. But you did a wonderful, wonderful job. And thank you to all of you who participated. I know many more people signed up who will be listening to this presentation.
Well, thank you. Thank you, Trish, for the opportunity
and
to share.
And we look forward to sharing it with as many people
thank
as
you.
Possible.
And thanks to Janet that was translating the Spanish slide.
So goodbye. Oh yes, go please do.
It was a challenge, Trish. Thank you. Thank you.
So is there anything else you would like to say to complete? I think we're reaching the end of our time
you,
together
Trish.
Today.
I will translate everything. Okay, Trish. Se está despidiendo y nos está dando las gracias por esta conversación y que también otras personas se han inscrito y que tendrán la oportunidad de verlo ya offline, o sea, no en vivo, sino porque se está grabando esta presentación. Así que muchísimas gracias a todos. Ha sido un reto esta conversación tanto en inglés como en español, pero salido todo como Dios ha querido. Gracias. Thank you, Trish.
Thank you, everyone. And I'll just say goodbye until we meet again.
Yes. Be kind with yourself because you are love.